गुड मॉर्निंग कैडेट्स, वी आर चेकिंग द रिवीजन पार्ट ऑफ चैप्टर राइज ऑफ नेशनलिज्म इन यूरोप. द प्रीवियस वीडियो सेशंस वी डिस्कस्ड अबाउट few 1 mark questions and few 2 or 5 mark questions. Today let us continue the leftover question and answers. Hope you are writing all those explain to you. The members of aristocracy were united by common way of life out of across the regional divisions. Question is that what are the features of aristocracy in Europe? Cadets, if you remember when we studied about French Revolution in class 9th and in class 10th also, the French society was divided into estate system, first, second and third estate. People belong to the second estate. Majority of them were aristocratic people or very very rich people. So aristocratic or rich people, whether in France, Germany, Italy and other European countries, numerically they were very very less in number. Even though they were numerically less in number, but economically they were very very powerful. If you could remember, after defeat of Napoleon Bonaparte in 1815 in the Battle of Waterloo, the France once again went under the control of Bourbon dynasty. That is the reason why the age of new conservatism started in Europe. Many European countries started feeling that to have political stability, it is better to have kingship or the rule by the king. Now, who spread this idea of to have a security, stability, better to have a kingship? Who spread this idea in European country? Idea was spread by the aristocratic people or the people who belongs to the royal family. So aristocratic across Europe, they had a common feature. That is what it is explained here. They owned estates and in the countryside as well as in the town side. So they had a huge land estates in the villages as well as in the towns. They spoke French for the purpose of diplomacy. So language they spoke is French language. They spoke for the purpose of diplomacy. Their families were connected with the ties of marriage. The common feature of aristocracy, the marriages were common or arranged between the aristocratic group of people. This powerful aristocracy was, however, numerically a small group. So numerically it was a small group, means the population or number wise they were very very less in number. That is what we speak about. Aristocracy was numerically very very less in number. That's the reason why they could not have much control in the later part of European history. Hope you are able to understand what I am speaking and explaining to you. Question number 11. establishment of empire in Northern Ireland. The treaty was drawn up with the objective of undoing most of the changes that had come about in Europe during Napoleonic War. So why the Treaty of Northern Ireland? What the Treaty of signed? Because to undo lot of things, which changes which were introduced by because of Napoleonic War. Bourbon dynasty restored to power in France. That is what I explained to you. After Battle of Waterloo, or after the Treaty of Vienna in 1815, Louis XVI, if you remember, Louis XVI belongs to Bourbon dynasty. So the same Bourbon dynasty were restored to power in France in the year 1815. Prussia was given new territories. So annexed kingdoms were also given to Prussia. The German Confederation of 39 states was left untouched. If you remember Zollern, what is Zollern? Zollern was a custom union across the provinces which were once ruled by Napoleon Bonaparte. So that's the reason why after the Battle of Waterloo, the German Confederation of 39 states was not, they are not made much change. It left untouched. So moving to the 12th, 13th, 14th and leftover questions. Equality before law. The concept of rule of law was introduced in this context only. If you remember the Jacobin Club under the leadership of Maximilian Robespierre ruled France. The period of Jacobin Club rule was called as Reign of Terror, even though it is called as Reign of Terror because of various drastic steps taken by Jacobin Club, which even went against the own club members. But what we have to remember here, Jacobin Club introduced a system in which all the birth-based privileges were abolished. That is what the beginning of equality before law. Not in favor of adult suffrage. Adult suffrage, there was not the universal adult suffrage because it is not given to all. Wanted to end ban on free market flow of goods by states. Question number 12. What is the question number 12, if you remember? What did European stands for political, social, economic in terms? So what is the question number 12? Question number 12 is saying, so in socially, liberalism stood for equality before law. But politically, liberalism is not supported universal adult franchise. That is what it says. What it supported? It supported the voting right for propertied men, one. The second, it is denied the voting right for women. So universal suffrage was not supported by the concept of liberalism. Then they wanted to put a ban on free market and flow of goods and states. So that is about the idea of liberty, liberalism. 13th, increase in industrial production in Western and Central Europe, rise of laborers and in the middle class, popularizing the ideas of ending special rights of aristocracy. So that is the answer to the question number 13. So that is the answer to the question number 13. What is the question number 13? How did industrialization change European social and economic equation? So how industrialization changed European social and economic equation? That is what. One of the great thing which we have to understand, the industrialization is responsible for birth of a new class of people which is called as working class or the labor class. And labor class or the working class, the major, there is a major role of this class in the future revolutions in any of the European countries. So the rise of laborers or the middle class population, and most of this labor or the middle class population were, they were educated, so as a result they demanded for put an end to the special rights provided to the aristocracy. 14th one, women had formed their own political association, founded newspapers, took part in political meetings and demonstrations. The participation of women, the participation of women in French Revolution or any where the participation of women in the revolution, that is what. So women had, they formed their own political associations, and of course they were very active in the field of revolution. Question number 15, 16 and 17. Okay, question number 15. In the 19th century, what were the reason for the wave of nationalism in Europe? So, question that, what is the reason for wave of nationalism in Europe? That is in the 19th century. Then, 16th one, discuss the three flaws of international economic exchange during 1815 to 1914. Then 17th one, why did Balkan area become an area of intense conflict? Why did Balkan area become area of intense conflict? That is what the question number 15, 16 and 17. I hope you are writing all these things. Let us check the answer. Absolute monarchy, rise in the liberal ideas, liberty, equality and fraternity, ideas of worth spreading, the rise of educated middle class. So here what you have to understand, that why there was a rise of nationalism in Europe in the leftover part of, means it was started in France with the French Revolution of 1789, slowly it spread in other parts of Europe. That's the reason why we could study about German unification, Italian unification, independence of Greece. Many countries, they revolted against monarchical rule and tried to bring freedom to the country. Why it has happened? That is what, the rise of liberal ideas, liberalism or freedom, especially the political freedom, economic freedom, social freedom. The people started showing the importance of the idea of freedom or liberty. The second, third important thing which explained the liberty, equality and fraternity. One of the greatest contribution of French Revolution to the world is the idea of liberty, equality and fraternity, that is brotherhood. So every country felt that the idea of liberty, equality and fraternity is definitely an idea which is worth spreading in other part of Europe. So that is why the ideas, they got sharp popularity. Another major reason is the rights of mid educated middle class population. The middle class population, I told you previously, industrialization gave the rise of working class population, and working class population or most of the educated middle class responsible for spreading and supporting the ideas of liberalism. It supported the flow of goods, flow of capital, flow of people. Now what is here we speak? The flow of goods, capital. Capital is nothing but the investment or money. So because of nationalization in Europe or the industrialization in European countries, what major changes took place is the goods and services started moving from place to place. If you could remember in class 8th onwards, there are many times when we studied Indian history, a lot of reference we have seen about Champaran movement, Kheda movement. If you could remember, a crop called indigo. Indians were forced to grow indigo, which was used as a coloring agent in, especially in Manchester City, where it is known famous for the manufacturing industries. So 19th century, early 18th and later part of 18th and 19th century, seen lot of flow of goods, maybe finished goods or raw materials. Raw materials like raw cotton, raw jute, indigo started flowing from India freely, and finished product, that is clothes, liquor, foreign liquor and all, British started dumping in the Indian market. At the same time, the flow of capital, the investment also started increasing because of the increasing of industrialization. That's the reason why the FICCI was formed in India, and whether other various companies started investing money in various countries. Flow of people. If you could remember, Sanyasi movement or the Begar system, indentured labor. So what are all these explains about the movement of people? And the industrialization was in the peak, especially British started taking people belong to the lower caste, especially from India and other African countries, and make them work as indentured labor in their colonies. So the system of indentured labor, Begar system, was started, and that increased the flow of people. So people, capital, goods started moving mainly because of industrialization. Why I explained you in detail? Because better you should understand the topic and concept so that you can explain in a better way. The last one is, that is 17th question about Balkan states. The Balkan states were seriously jealous of each other. Each hoped to gain more territory than at the expense of others. Balkan also became a scene of big power rivalry. The big European powers were working in holding its control over Balkan and extending its control over the region. Now, why Balkan province later considered as major reason for intense rivalry as well as resulted in First World War? I told you, Balkan province was controlled by Ottoman Kingdom. When Ottoman Kingdom lost its supremacy, naturally all those countries which were once controlled by Balkan Ottoman Empire, they started declaring war against themselves, war against the neighboring nations. As a result, there was intense rivalry. That is what the point explains, that each hoped to gain more territory at the expense of others. The Balkan also became a scene of big power rivalry. The big European powers were working in holding its control over Balkan and extending its control over the region. So that is the major reason why Germany involvement of Turkey was there in the First World War against Britain in favor of Germany. These are all about the Balkan province. So cadets, what we done in the last two video, okay, let me explain at least. Okay, yes, please go through. Yeah, from here answer on starts quickly. Unification of then British Isles, effects of France on the world, 10th, 11th. So with this cadets, I completed a revision of Rise of Nationalism in Europe. We have done extreme exercise of searching for new questions and all those things. And the next video session, I'll start from the civics topics. Thank you. Wish you a wonderful day. Thank you.